pretty simmers. It's pretty pretty plum bobs here for the first time ever with my face to talk to you guys about the new Eco Living trailer. I am not super excited for this pack, and I'll tell you why as we sort of go through everything really like in detail and in depth. I've tried to like really look at every single frame of this video and like pick out exactly what's new, what's different, and what there is to be excited about. So that being said, let's go ahead and jump into it. You guys, so we open up on this very like smoggy world. It looks like there's a lot of like bigger sort of world objects like you might use in live edit mode or debug, but unless you're a builder, you probably won't use them much for gameplay. And then we have this girl here, she's coughing. It looks like she has some tattoos and gauges, which is something I noticed a couple times. A hairstyle we don't have, and like a turtleneck sweater we don't have. So there's some create a sim assets there that look like probably things that are new. Not my style in particular. Gauges, I guess, are cool. That's the type of thing that I know like a lot of people probably be really excited for. But I don't know. I just don't care. I'll probably make one sim with gauges ever. Then we have this dumpster diving scene here, and something's related to it. It maybe looks like one guy gets like in a herd of flies or something, and then this guy jumps into the dumpster and another sim is there with a bag over her head, which I do not know why she has a bag over her head. Dumpster diving is like an okay activity. I bet you can find like collectibles and stuff from it. I remember we had this, you could go into like people's garbage cans in The Sims 3, which I kind of liked. I had like a private detective sim in The Sims 3 that did that a lot, but I can't say it's a feature I've like really missed or needed. So I don't know. It'd be cool if you could maybe get like furniture or something like that. Let me guys know what you think about dumpster diving. I'm again not too excited about it, unfortunately. Next we have the house, which I'm kind of breezing past because I actually don't find it that interesting. Actually, the windows on it I think are like base game. It doesn't look like there's too many new features. We have like corrugated metal kind of look and like kind of like a tiny house. Obviously, we've had a lot of tiny houses for a long time now in The Sims. Next we move on to this like weird trash compactor thingy. There's some objects in the background. I'm gonna be honest, none of them excite me, especially those like little weird bike things because they don't look usable. And then she puts her trash in and makes a cube. So I don't know if you can maybe use that for scraps, for building things, for the 3D printer we see later. So from here, we move on to something that appears to be a candle making station. Ha ha ha. I actually find this really funny. I am a huge candle person in real life. I make my own candles often. I like to use soy wax blends and that sort of thing. But candles are actually terrible for the environment. Most modern candles are made of paraffin wax, which is actually like a carcinogen when you burn it. It's made from like crude oil and like petroleum, and it's actually a terrible thing that supports the oil industry in the long run. So the fact that it's kind of like included as like a environmental thing in this pack is like kind of weird. Also, we have had a mod in the community for a long time that is a candle making pack, and it looks at least as good as this. I don't know. I feel very conflicted because like I said, I love candles. I make candles. I'd love my like witchy Sims to make candles. But at the same time, like, does it go with the theme? I'm not sure. So the next thing is we get this kind of like saga of voting to turn this sort of desolate piece of polluted land into a park, which is okay. I honestly don't have that many opinions on that. I don't really need that in my game personally, but I could see why somebody would find that kind of gameplay exciting. But I will say that we in this particular screenshot, you can see that there actually is what looks like a food truck or trailer in the background, which I think is a really cute idea. I might really be into that. Another thing is on one of the foremost tables, you can see that there's like bottles being sold. So even though we kind of have the like selling tables and the ability to do that already in the game, it looks like these might be like something like homebrewed kombucha or homemade soda or something like that. I don't know how that would be made or how you would get those items, but if that is what it is, like, I think that's a pretty cool idea and something I would be excited about. So sorry for my negativity overall, but there's a lot of things in this particular picture that actually excite me. Moving on to the finished garden pick, we do have a couple more Create-A-Sim assets that look really cute in here. The dress, the pink dress with the belt looks cute, and overalls and those sorts of things. And then the biggest thing is the walls garden, which does seem to be fully functional. Like, it looks like the girl who's standing there is watering it, and those all look like harvestable plants. So that's a cool gameplay feature. And then we have this, and if this is what I think it is, this is what I'm most excited about more than anything else in the pack, and what I think it is a chicken coop. I would love to have chickens. I hope you'd be able to, like, interact with the chickens, have them run around. I don't know if it's just an object in the way that like the bees are an object, where you can go interact with that thing, but they like live in there and you can't really like see the chickens. But it does look like he takes a baby chicken out and holds it in his hand, which is already super cute. So again, I think this kind of depends how they do it. From here, we move directly onto the thing I'm probably least excited about from this whole trailer, and that is what looks like a 3D printer. It also really looks like the invention machine from Get to Work. I'll try and put like a picture clip here of that if I can find it, but it seems to be the exact same animation, and I can only assume it'll work the same way where you kind of like move through different inventions or levels or something. Also, the thing she invents is kind of weird. It's like an air sucking pollution device. I don't know. I personally am not excited about that at all. I feel like the Sims team was kind of sitting there being like, what's trendy? What do the kids like? Oh, 3D printers, that'll be cool. I don't know. We already have a gameplay object that is so similar to this in the inventing thingy from Get to Work. So just not something I'm super excited to see. Moving right along, you guys, we see the windmills and the windmills, is that the right term? Wind turbines and the solar panels on the house. I think these could be really cool depending how they do them. If there's some kind of like energy feedback system, maybe you can make some extra money off of it. I do like this idea, and I think if it's done well, it could be really cool in the game. And then we get a train station image. If this is usable in any way, if they have like trains delivering things or something like that, I think that could be also a really cool feature. But it's just too early to say with so much of this stuff. Next thing we get is what is probably our best view of the world. And you do see a view, very beautiful like mountain view in the back, which feels a little bit like the Glimmerbrook world from Realm of Magic, but obviously a little bit more suburban. It kind of reminds me of Colorado. I have family out there, I've been there a lot, so that's kind of the vibe I'm getting, and Colorado is obviously a place that is very like eco-friendly, so I wonder if the world isn't going to be a little bit inspired by that. But let me know what you guys think in the comments about the world, because I'm kind of just like speculating here. Finally, we get this sort of like party scene on the roof where you can see a lot of different Create-A-Sim items. So I really like the red dress going on kind of on the left-hand side. But everything else, like, I feel like it's subjective. I feel like some of it I could use, some of it I wouldn't. Let me know if there's any, like, Create-A-Sim items in this video that you're, like, super excited about or feel like you couldn't live without. For me, like, nothing is, like, so standing out of me, like, oh my god, I can't wait to have that. But there are some cute-looking pieces. It's actually one of my dreams in life to see the Northern Lights in person. So that I actually think is very cool, and I will live vicariously on that one through my Sims. So just some final thoughts. The Sims team has been teasing for a while that they're bringing like all new things that have never been seen in The Sims before to the franchise. And I don't feel like eco living is that, like, hasn't been seen before. We had eco-themed traits in The Sims 3. In The Sims 4, we actually have the Sulani cleanup. We have off-the-grid lots. We also have like bicycles and stuff. So a lot of that eco gameplay is kind of there if you're looking for it. So it doesn't feel as like new and fresh of a theme as I was kind of like expecting for the next expansion pack. At the same time, I think a lot of the quality of what they're going to give us is going to depend on the gameplay, and I don't think we've seen a lot of that yet. So if they really flesh out these themes with like a positive gameplay experience, hopefully it will be a really amazing pack and will exceed all of my expectations and hopefully all of the Sims community's expectations as well. It would be nice to see a win for the Sims team. So whether you are new here to my channel or you are a returning subscriber, I want to say hi in person. My name is Samantha, but I go by Pretty Pretty Bloom Bobs. I release new Sims videos mostly on Mondays and Thursdays, but this is sort of a special edition for the trailer. Please do like, subscribe, comment if you're interested in seeing more content. As a brand new YouTuber, it helps me out so much. You cannot imagine. And also just on a personal level, I really love connecting with you guys. I really love reading through all my comments, and I really love getting to know other people in the Sims community. So don't be shy, say hi below, and other than that, I will see you tomorrow for a brand new video. Thank you for watching. Smell soul, y'all.